Hi, it's Alena from DataCamp, and welcome to our DataCamp 101 video series, where we explore best practices to help you get started with your learning journey and maximize your learning outcomes. Today, we'll focus on the most straightforward way to get started through assignments and tracks, how to search for courses, assessments, and projects, how the learning experience looks like on DataCamp, and how to stay on track with your learning goals. Learning with DataCamp is fun, so let's explore how to enjoy it to the fullest. Before we jump into the platform, let's make sure you got access to your DataCamp subscription. Check your email from DataCamp for an invitation to join your DataCamp group. Once you create an account and log in, you should see your home dashboard. If you haven't received an invitation, try to sign up with your work email from datacamp.com. Your admins might have enabled single sign-on access. If, after logging in, you still see an upgrade button, reach out to your learning and development team or your team manager to ask to invite you to a DataCamp group. Once you settle in DataCamp, navigate to the Learn Hub, the one-stop shop for your data and AI learning. At DataCamp, our philosophy is to learn by doing, and we will always get you to apply what we teach to real-world challenges. DataCamp offers more than 430-plus interactive courses, 100-plus real-life projects, 25-plus case studies, 90-plus curated learning paths, 60-plus practice sessions, and 20-plus skill assessments. It is easy to get lost in this vast learning catalog. But right now, we will share the best ways to get started. What we see over and over again is that most successful learners start by completing an assignment or enrolling in a track. To check if you have an assignment, scroll down to the assignment section of your Learn Hub. Here you will see the assignment type and the deadline by which you need to complete it. If you have an assignment, start from there, and you will be rewarded with experience points after completing it. XPs, or experience points, are one of the reasons why it is fun to learn on DataCamp. You get points for completing almost any content. Then you can use XPs to compete with other learners within your group and get exercise hints if you get stuck. If there are no assignments, don't worry. Just check occasionally if you receive any and pay attention to your email and in-app notifications. After completing an assignment, enrolling in the track is the next best way to keep learning. At DataCamp, we have three types of tracks: organization tracks, skill tracks, and career tracks. Tracks typically consist of interactive courses, assessments, and projects. Let's start with organization tracks. Organization tracks are tailored learning paths created by your learning managers. We highly recommend enrolling on one of the organization tracks because they are specifically designed to meet the needs of your organization. To register on the track, open the track and hit the button Enroll. Doing so will add the learning paths to your Learn and Home dashboards, making it easy to continue learning. If you have no organization tracks so far, try exploring our curated learning paths. To pick up the right track for you, consider your learning goals. Do you want to become better at a particular skill or technology? Or do you want to make a career switch or get a promotion? DataCamp skill tracks help you fill in specific skill gaps, whether it's understanding Power BI and Tableau fundamentals, importing clean data with Python, data manipulation with R, or data storytelling best practices. You will find something to suit your needs. Skill tracks usually take around 10 to 20 hours to complete. Career tracks help you get a structured path for a career transition, completing onboarding, or getting a promotion. They help you master a set of skills required for a certain role, and usually take 40 to 100 hours to complete. Suppose you want to start a career as a data scientist. You can choose from data scientist with R, data scientist with Python, or extended data scientist professional career tracks. Career tracks are usually a big commitment, so discuss your learning goals with your manager before you start. To help stay focused, we made it possible to enroll on only one track at a time. If you enroll on a particular track and decide to switch it later on, you can always do so by hitting the Switch Track button. If you have completed specific courses, assessments, or projects, they will be counted towards any track that features them. We've discussed assignments and tracks as the best way to get started on DataCamp. But if you have a more granular learning goal, the best way to find specific learning content is via the search bar. Type what you are looking for, and DataCamp will suggest courses, projects, assessments, tutorials, webinars, and podcasts that might be relevant to you. I've mentioned multiple times that learning with DataCamp is fun, so let's see exactly why and dive into the intermediate SQL course. Every course on DataCamp is structured in chapters. Every chapter starts with a short 3 to 4 minute video. You can switch on subtitles, see the transcript, change the playback speed, and download the video to access it offline. After watching the video, you will get experience points and move on to the exercises. All exercises in DataCamp are interactive. For example, you can type and execute SQL code and submit your answer with one click. Let's complete this exercise and receive our well-deserved XPs. DataCamp will always get you practically apply what we teach. Bridging the gap between learning and doing gives you the confidence you need to apply this knowledge in the real world. If at some point you need to get back to course material, you can always revisit the video and the slides without leaving the exercise. We also recommend taking course notes using DataCamp Workspace. Workspace is a cloud data science notebook that will store your text notes, code, and datasets, so you can always return to your learnings. We'll talk about Workspace in more detail in our next video. If you make a mistake in the exercise, DataCamp will highlight it for you, giving you a chance to correct it. If you get stuck while learning, you can spend some of your experience points to get a hint. And if the hint doesn't help, you can reveal the answer. You won't get any experience points for completing the exercise if you show the answer. DataCamp makes learning interactive regardless of the topic and technology. If you decide to learn Power BI and Tableau, DataCamp will open the interface right in the browser, meaning you don't need to install any additional software. If you aim to build foundational data literacy, you will also learn with bite-sized videos and interactive multiple-choice, drag-and-drop, and single-choice exercises. If you have a busy schedule, DataCamp offers a mobile app to learn on the go. There you can complete specific courses and practice exercises, and even listen to podcasts and learn from tutorials. Some content can't be taught in a compelling and interactive way on a mobile screen, like certain BI tools. You can always take these courses on your desktop. To check if the course is available on mobile, scan these QR codes to download our app for Android and iOS and search for your course there. Alternatively, you can check whether a course is available for mobile on your desktop. If there is a mobile icon in the top right corner, then the course is available on your mobile app. After completing the course, you can download and share your course completion certificate. Check completed courses from the Learn Hub page, open the course you want to save the certificate for, and share it how you want. You can also bookmark interesting courses to come back to them later. At DataCamp, our philosophy is learn by doing, and this is why, on top of courses, we provide interactive assessments, practice exercises, and projects to help you further build your data and AI skills. First, let's cover assessments. Assessments are awesome in helping you identify your skill gaps. DataCamp assessments consist of 10 timed questions that adapt to your answers as you go. If you answer an easy question correctly, the next question will move up the difficulty spectrum, and vice versa. This helps us assess your skill level fairly and put it on a scale from beginner to advanced, while calibrating it with other DataCamp learners' results. After completing an assessment, you will understand your core strengths as well as get an insight into how you can bridge your skill gaps with personalized learning recommendations. If by this time you haven't yet decided which courses or tracks to prioritize, assessments help shape your learning goals. Second, after completing DataCamp courses, it is essential to reinforce learning with practice exercises. This is just how our brains work. If you don't repeat and practice learnings regularly, you will likely forget them. DataCamp offers 65 plus practice sessions, and we are continuously adding more. DataCamp will mark the practice pool as ready for practice if you have completed a related course. Each practice pool consists of 5 interactive questions. You can take practice pools multiple times as questions get reshuffled. Last but not least, you can leverage DataCamp projects and case studies to apply your learning to real-world datasets. Let's first cover projects. DataCamp projects allow you to apply SQL, Python, and R skills on real-world datasets. They are powered by DataCamp Workspace, and all the data and packages are already pre-configured so that you can start solving your task right away. There are two types of projects, guided and unguided. Guided projects feature step-by-step instructions to help you understand data science workflows, whereas unguided projects are aimed at more advanced learners who solve challenges without extra support. Case studies focus on applying Power BI, Tableau, and theoretical knowledge in real business scenarios. For example, you will complete a chart analysis in Power BI to answer real-world data questions. Now that we've covered the learning content available on DataCamp, let me share some tips to stay on track with your learning. First, it is crucial to make learning your habit. On the homepage, you can check out your learning streak. Even completing 5-minute exercises on your mobile phone can help cement the habit. Second, staying focused is essential. From the homepage, you can quickly jump to the track, course, or project you've started completing. And last but not least, schedule your learning. Choose a day when you will allocate time for learning and add reminders to your calendar. To find more tips on fitting learning into a busy schedule, check out DataCamp Learner Stories in the video description. In this video, we've covered essentials that will help you settle on DataCamp. We've discussed the best way to start with assignments and tracks, what the learning experience looks like, how to get a personalized learning plan with assessments, and explored ways to practice and apply your skills with practice sessions, projects, and case studies. In the next video, we'll cover other ways to achieve your data ambitions with DataCamp. We'll talk in more detail about certifications, skill verifications, DataCamp Workspace, competitions, leaderboards, and more.